Now let's solve some of the examples regarding this in order to understand canonical delta. First is del ij del j del jk equals to del ik, which can be easily shown as one of the property also. This equals to curl xi over curl xj, curl xj over curl xk equals to curl xi over curl xk, which is nothing but equals to del ik. We can also solve this in a similar way as if I say that there is no summation over k, so del I 1 del 1 k plus del I 2 del 2 k and so on as del I k del k k. Okay, so all the indices will become to 0 and a single one left, which is equals to del I k. Okay, now move to the second question, that curl x k over curl x bar I, curl x bar I over curl x j, which is nothing but equals to del k j simply. Our next example is that if a alpha beta x alpha x beta is equals to 0 for all values of the variable x1, x2 up to xn, then show that this relation exists. So let us suppose that this quantity a alpha x beta is equals to big A. As this whole quantity is equals to 0, so a is also equals to 0. Differentiating a with respect to xi, this will be equals to a alpha beta curl x alpha over curl xi, which is equals to Dirac delta function. So curl alpha over I x beta, and again a alpha beta plus x alpha curl x beta over curl xi, which is again Dirac delta beta I Kronecker delta. Now alpha equals to I, then our equation changes to, when alpha equals to I, our equation changes to AI beta X beta plus, and beta is equals to I, A alpha I alpha. Okay, again differentiating this with respect to xj, equals to a I beta curl xb over curl xj, which is equals to del beta j a alpha I curl x alpha over curl x j, which is equals to del alpha j. Now when alpha equals to j and beta equals to j, our equation will be converted into a I j plus a j I, which is all equals to 0. As a equals to 0, so is differentiation, and this second differentiation also equals to 0. Now moving to the theorem, Kronecker delta is a mixed tensor of rank 2. Now we know that Kronecker delta del ij can be represented as curl x bar I over curl x bar j, which can also be written as curl x bar I over curl x k by the chain property, chain rule, curl x bar j which is equals to 1 if I equals to j and 0 if I not equals to j. Now again using the chain rule, curl x bar I over curl x k, say this time L, curl x k over curl x bar j, curl x L over curl x k, okay, which is again by chain rule, and this will become equals to del L k, curl x bar I over curl x L, and curl x k over curl x bar j, del L k. Now we can see that this is a contravariant component, this is a covariant component, which makes this Dirac delta of second order a mixed tensor.